dentist and the dark. I was scared of pretty girls and starting conversations. All my friends are turning green. Yeah, the magician's assistant in their dreams.
TV of the year. We are happy to be back and are excited to bring you everything Father Lopez. I'm Alexa Hill.
And I'm the Nick Eastman. College acceptances are off to a great start because here at Father Lopez, we work harder than anyone else. We are proud to announce college acceptances for the following seniors. Congratulations, Zach Pollins, who has been accepted into the University of Alabama. Paige Ward with her acceptance to the University of North Florida. Andrew Gafrida, Florida Gulf Coast University. University of Alabama, and University of North Florida. Marina DeRosa, University of North Florida, and Shona Whitfield, Florida Atlantic University.
In addition to our college acceptances, we are also proud to announce that Jake Lambert has enlisted in the United States Marine Corps. Jake will begin his service this summer following graduation. Congratulations, Jake.
Congrats, ma'am.
Director of Alumni Relations, Mrs. McIntyre, wants you to know that plans are well underway for the annual Welcome Home Alumni Reception. The reception will take place prior to the homecoming football game on Friday, October the 17th from 5:30 until game time. If you have any brothers or sisters or friends that are alumni, please bring them.
The first Father Lopez Rosary Bowl was a huge success. Over 200 of our community members gathered in our gym for a time of reflection and prayer last Wednesday night. They did a great job gathering together and recognizing our Catholic identity. Thank you to all the parents and students who volunteered and took the time to make it a very special night and a huge success.
Are you looking for service hours? We've got the place for you. Find Miss Galethco for new opportunities for student service. They are announced every single week. These volunteer opportunities are a great way for our students to help others in the community while fulfilling their service hour requirement.
These things are very informational. Did you know that? They can give us service hours. But no. People choose to neglect and ignore them. Bulletin boards have feelings too. Just remember that. Here's an example of what people do to bulletin boards. Here's some examples of what you should do. A King of the Grill competition. I can cook, and I'm the king. I'm very interested. Now I can get some service hours from it.
Lopez Catholic High School is proud to announce the 4th annual Booster Club Christmas Tree and Wreath fundraiser. These beautiful hand-cut trees are fresh and delivered directly to the school on Sunday, November 30th. Proceeds from the sale directly support Father Lopez Athletics. For more information, please call 386-562-6430.
Once again, 386-562-6430.
Hey, that's my mommy.
We are very excited to announce some precious new members of the Father Lopez community. Mrs. Rivera has been blessed with a granddaughter named Tatiana Sophia, and Will Hill, our school handyman, is now a first-time father to a gorgeous Jackson Lee Hill.
This year, Lopez welcomes international students from 9 different countries: Canada, China, Colombia, France, Germany, Latvia, Thailand, Vietnam, and the Dominican Republic. Most students come here to improve their English and learn about American culture. However, others plan to stay to graduate from high school in the United States. The time spent with us varies from 1 month to 4 years. Shout out to my boy Mark from Canada.
Want to perform in the talent show this year? Sign up with Mrs. Wade in room 503 by this Thursday. Okay. We missed that. It's that time of the year again, everyone.
Homecoming.
Homecoming week. Dress days, decades day on Monday. Freshmen are 60s themed, sophomores are 70 AD, juniors are 70s, and seniors are 50s. At lunch, there is Twister and Bingo in the cafeteria and voting for King and Queen. Hallway decorating contest after school. Tuesday is awareness day. Bring $3 or you have to wear a uniform. Freshmen are wearing orange, sophomores camouflage, juniors blue, seniors in red. Walk around the track after sports, and lunch there's capture the flag and football on the field. Wednesday is early dismissal with PSATs and senior pitcher day. Thursday is class dress. Freshmen are America themed, sophomores are Hawaiian shirts, and juniors it's twin day. Seniors camouflage day, and the Powder Puff semifinals are on Thursday as well, and the pep rally at 6:30. Friday is spirit dress, also activities day, and there's a talent show, Powder Puff finals, boots, and money, and boys volleyball. Homecoming football at 7 p.m., crowning of king and queen. Saturday's homecoming dance at 8:30 to 11 p.m.
My name is Michael Corey, and it's an honor and privilege for me to be able to serve as the president of Father Lopez Catholic High School. It's with pleasure that we share with you our 2014 Annual Report magazine. In doing so, I want to thank you. I thank you for your prayers, I thank you for your interest, and I thank you for your support of Father Lopez Catholic High School and the students we serve. And speaking of students, let's hear from a few of them at this time.
till I give my money right. Oh, 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 oh. Why do we play? Oh, oh. Can we start?
I'm Ryan Moen.
And I'm Case Lissard.
And this is the Father Lopez Sports Report. I don't know if you know, but we have a new athletic director here at Lopez.
We would like to welcome Scott Drabzik to the Lopez community.
Yeah, dude was a five-star recruit, and after spending 4 years as AD at Ocoee High School, we will be expecting big things from this talented man.
Father Lopez also welcomes a new coach on the diamond.
As a former standout at Eastridge High School and Embry-Riddle, Coach Greg Smith is a solid role model for everyone on the team.
Sounds like a stand-up guy.
The football team is off to a great start on the gridiron with a 2-2 record. Moen, tell us about this new brand of football.
After a tough loss to our sister school, MCC, we won our first district game against PK Young in Gainesville. The 6-0 victory included a 7-yard touchdown run by Marquise Williams. Friday night, we played a tough Mount Verde. This Friday at 7, we will play McClay at home. This is our homecoming game, so please come out and show your support.
Any big wins?
We won against our biggest rival, Warner Christian. Before this year, we haven't beat the team in 9 years. Brant Williams had a great game, highlighted by a huge punt return and an 80-yard reception on the first play of the night. Both went for huge touchdowns.
Volleyball is also off to a great start. They are 4-0 in their district. This week, they take on the Mainland Bucks.
Golf and cross country also off to a strong start in the individual and team competitions. The golf team won a tough match against Cypress Knolls last Wednesday. Cross country also performed well at their Disney meet, one of their toughest meets of the year.
We would also like to congratulate our Jersey Mike's Athletes of the Week. We've had 6 so far this year. CJ Williams, football.
Paige Ward, cross country.
Emma Albrecht, golf.
Maddie Young, volleyball.
Logan LaCroix, golf.
Nick Theriot, cross country.
Bailey Gillespie, volleyball.
And Jahid Chowdhury for swimming.
It seems there's a sport we've forgotten to mention. Shout out to the Lopez swim team who has stroked their way to a blazing start. The boys racked up 2 big wins, trouncing Mainland 64-32 and Matanzas 61-33. The girls would top the Bucks 60-32, but were edged by the Pirates of Matanzas.
That's all from us here at the Lopez Sports Report.
Wow, that's great news.
Congrats, guys.
I am Alexa Hill.
And I'm Nick Eastman.
This was Wave TV, and never forget to stay classy, Paul Lopez. We need to do that again.
I'm going to cry. I'm just going to lay down.
Wow. That's great news. Wow. That's great news. Wow. That's great news.